either you are a materialist or a spiritualist or both or neither. Whatever it may be, bliss is the ultimate goal for everyone in their life. The bliss is continuously happening in our being. Of course, around the world, all the intelligent people, not only in the field of spirituality, even in the field of science, they say, whatever we search is already existing. If it is not existing, we cannot search.
If you say we search for bliss, it means it was there. Only thing we have forgotten. Just like a headache. There was a time when you did not have headache. So the memory of that calls you back, inspires you to come out of headache. The same way, there was a time you had joy, you had bliss, you had total peace. Whatever the great qualities you call, bliss, love, beauty, energy, all those moments were there in your life. You have tasted it, you have experienced it. It is your basic life. Only thing we forgot. Due to some reason, we have forgotten it. It has become a forgotten language. So now, in these 2 days, you will learn how to uncover or how to clear the mud and the stones accumulated around the fountain. We will again start the fountain, the Ananda Spurana. We will again taste the bliss fountain, which is continuously happening in you. You are just supposed to let it happen. You need nothing to be done. You need only one thing. Just allow the thing to happen. The class can be used in 3 ways. You can use this course in 3 ways. One, intellectually. If you just sit with your head, with your attention, you will have an intellectual result. If you just attend this class intellectually, it can be used as a stress management course. Of course, it is nice, but not enough. It is nice, but not enough. Just you can manage your stress. You can balance your life. That much it will help. If you attend with a little bit of emotion, with a little bit of sincerity, it can give you the glimpse of bliss. You will have at least one glimpse of Ananda in someone meditation. One glimpse where you taste the no-mind feeling or the no-mind experience. If you put your whole effort, these 2 days, this weekend will not be just a weekend, it will be an end for all your weaknesses. It will be weakness end, not simple weekend. It can change your whole life. You may say, how just 2 days can change my life? How just 2 days can change my life? If thousands of years a room was dark, it is not that to lit that room you need 1,000 more years. No. The room may be dark, room may be dull for thousands of years because of no light. But you don't need 1,000 more year to lit the room. Just bring a lamp, bring a candle, you will see in a moment the darkness has disappeared. So intellectually you cannot understand. The darkness was lying there 1,000 years. It was staying there. Legally it has become a resident, a owner of that room. How can we drive the darkness out in a minute? Of course, legally or intellectually you cannot understand. Court of law cannot prove God. Court of law or logic can never prove the life. Life is nothing to do with logic. Of course, logic has something to do with life, but life has nothing to do with logic. Understand, darkness may be residing in your heart thousands and thousands of years, but it is not that. It is a permanent thing. Thousands of years it may reside, but it has no green card, it has got only visa. Any moment you can send him out. Only one thing, just your understanding, your sharp decision. If you put your whole effort, it can just change your whole life. It will not be just weekend, it will be a weakness end. Put your whole effort. That is the only way to take the maximum from this class. If you are attending for the first time, be very clear. You will be able to get the result only by putting your whole effort in every meditation technique. If you are attending for a second time, understand, put your effort 120%, because last time you missed. If you are first time, put 100% effort. If you are second time, put 120% effort. You have missed last time. That is why you are here again. So, don't miss at least this time. The whole class, you will be learning to deal with your emotions, with your mind, ultimately with your life. Never think, oh, after all these are meditation techniques, I'll go and practice in the house. No. If you can't practice here, how will you practice in the house? So please don't postpone. We have a mind. Our mind, mental structure is such, we always postpone. We try to take the notes. That is why I discourage taking notes. Never go for taking notes. Try to work. Don't create workbook, because you have thousands of workbooks. It is not that we don't have workbooks. We have thousands of workbooks and owner's manuals. Only thing, we don't work. The workbook cannot satisfy. Only working can satisfy. So put your effort, put your attention, put your energy to work, not to create a workbook. Even in your mind, don't bother about recalling all these things. I have seen many people, mentally they try to recall everything and they miss the next statements. Don't bother about recalling. If you understand, well and good. If you don't understand, again well and good. Don't worry about it. Put your effort into the meditations. That is more than enough. Of course, whenever you feel, what I am talking is not relating with you. Never think I am talking to the next person. I am not talking to a generalized group. It is not a political meeting. For political meeting, generalized talk is necessary. Generalization means continuously telling lies. A small story. After a 1 hour lecture by the president, one reporter asked, "Sir, I heard your whole lecture, but what is your stand on abortion bill? Please explain about it." Even after listening 1 hour, we are not able to understand what is your stand on the abortion bill. The president said, "Oh, that is nice. My secretary has done a wonderful job after 1 hour work." He says, "It took 10 hours for my secretary to write a whole lecture such a way that nobody understand what stand I am taking." To tell a lie, you need to generalize the whole thing. I am not generalizing the whole thing. Here, I am talking to every one of you. So whenever you feel, I am not relating with you, just raise your hands and question. If you feel what I am talking is not for you, immediately you are welcome to stop and crisscross me with your questions. Be very clear. Never think what Swami is speaking for somebody else. Every step is just for you. Every step is just for you. Few tips to have the total benefit. Put your total effort. You must have attended a lot of spiritual discourses. You must have heard enough of the spiritual stuff. Or you must have read enough of things. Just for these 2 days, keep them all little aside from your mind. If you keep them all little aside, you will have fresh mind to understand what I say. If you have enough of stuff already in your mind, either you will be playing the game of accepting me or playing the game of rejecting me. Both games are not going to work. If you try to accept me, again you will miss me, because you accepted thousands of philosophers but you never practice. If you try to reject me, of course there is no relationship happens. When you reject me, the relationship never happens. When you accept me, again you accept me just like one more philosopher, it never penetrates your life. I say neither accept nor reject, just try to give a chance for me. Try, just like a scientific hypothesis, when something is given to you, you try to work it out, you try to see whether it works in your life or not. So give a small trial, nothing more than that. Don't start believing or don't start disbelieving. Think, oh, here is something new, let us try to work out. When you reject, nothing enters in your mind. When you accept, you classify it, you downhole it. You think, oh, already I have heard from that Swami. Oh, he speaks exactly like JK. He speaks exactly like Chinmayananda. Somewhere, whatever you heard, you will compare and downhole me also. But by downholing, you will miss the whole thing. You will miss the whole process. Please don't downhole it. The course is going to be more or less mingled with physical exercises where you need to put your physical effort. It is not going to be just a mental visualizations. Meditation means we always have a thought. It is going to be just mental visualization. But according to the masters, body and mind are not two separate things. According to doctors, body and mind are two separate things. According to masters, body and mind are not two separate things. They call it body mind. There is no separate body and mind. The same space, it cannot be even called as a material, it's a space. Your body is a space. The space which has become a matter. Your mind is a space which is subtle. The subtle portion of the space is called mind. The physical portion, the material portion of the space is called body. The overall space itself is called spirit. That's all. The space is a spirit. In the space, something is material, that is body. Something is subtle, something is energy, that is mind. So we are going to work on both levels, body and mind. It is going to be more or less like an alchemy process. We will be adding one by one, A plus B plus C plus D. It will be one by one additions. So don't miss someone session. Don't think, if I miss one session, I will miss only 1/7 of the course. No. If you miss one session, don't think you will miss only one chakra. The whole alchemy process you will miss. It is like an alchemy process. A step by step, you will be taken in within your being. So don't miss the alchemy process. Don't miss even a single session. And don't forget to put your whole effort even in single session. And don't worry about any of your pains, any of your problems. You may be thinking, oh, I have this pain, I have that pain, how can I do the meditation? And don't worry about it. Your mind will create enough of problems, enough of difficulty to avoid you meditating. Meditation and mind are just daughter-in-law and mother-in-law. They cannot stay in the house. How much you try, you will try from morning till evening. At the end, when you come back to the house, you will understand all your trials have led to where. Both try to possess a same person. The same thing happens to you. If you allow the mind to possess you, the meditation cannot possess you. If you allow the meditation to possess you, mind cannot possess you. So mind knows, just like every being in the universe, mind also wants to survive. So it creates its own mechanism for self-survival. So it creates enough of doubts, enough of problems, enough of complications to stop you entering into the state of meditation. First thing, it will create a physical pains and physical troubles. Next thing, it will create a psychological fears. Oh, what will happen if this happens because of this meditation? If that happens because of that meditation? Oh, in my neighborhood, somebody has gone to meditation and he has become very weak. After that, somebody has gone to this meditation, he has become mad. You get some detail, some data somewhere and confuse yourself. Don't worry. These meditation techniques are foolproof techniques. Around the world, thousands are practicing. So I take the responsibility for the techniques. Put your whole effort. That's all. Nothing else needs to be done. Else will be taken care by itself. So hereby, we are creating a space in which you are supposed to flower. The flowering of bliss can happen to you. First, we will all introduce ourselves to each other. You may think, why? Unless you introduce yourself to each other, you will not feel comfortable. For next 2 days, many of you are going to sit next to each other. Somebody will be sitting next to you, somebody will be sitting in front of you, somebody will be rear you. So many will be sitting around you. If you don't know the other person, you will not feel comfortable. I've always seen, whenever I say, close your eyes and tie the ribbon, people always look at the other, whether he closed his eyes or not, whether she has tied the ribbon or not. So if you know the other person, you will be comfortable. You will be able to relax easily. So that is the only reason I tell you, go around, introduce yourself to everyone, and you will be comfortable. Please go around. We'll go for the next session. Actually, the time for introduction is given not only to introduce, so that you will not speak later on. If this time is not given, we will be continuously talking even till tomorrow evening. And moreover, the mind means curious. It is just a curiosity. You will have a simple curiosity to know about the other. That's the reason. Separate space or time is given to introduce with everyone. Please don't sleep. And that is the reason the whole class is kept in a very interactive way. It will not be like a regular discourses. It will be more or less like an interaction. You'll be free. In a way, you are welcome to question anything. Don't think, oh, this question is not appropriate. This question is not right. I may look like a fool. I tell you one thing. When you question, you may look like a fool. When you don't, you are a fool. When you question, you may look like. When you don't, you are. So, don't bother about, I may look like a fool and all those things. Any question, just come up. It is not even the question. The main thing is, you are opening up. You are opening up. It says, it proves you are still not yet asleep. You are active. Just for that, you are listening. The interaction is happening. So come up with any question. Never think some question is silly. All questions are silly. So let us be very clear. Anytime you can come up with any question, any thought pops up your mind, bring it out. Verbalize it. Try to relate.